Yo, friends, welcome back to the channel. Nice to review here, back at it again with another action figure review. We're gonna be jumping back into the Marvel toy box because I hit up the Disney store yesterday when I went to the city and I found Miles Morales. Pretty cool. I did not know this thing existed. I didn't even know they were coming out with a Miles Morales version of the Spider-Man. So it's pretty cool. New sculpt. It's not a repaint of this one like other figures might be. But yeah, it's a completely new sculpt. Everything's almost new on this guy, with a few minor, I guess upgrades to this figure. But yeah, other than that, we're gonna be taking a look at number 3 action figure, Spider-Man, from the Marvel Toy Box, and number 14 action figure, Miles Morales. And they both come with the same accessory, so that's a kind of a little boring, right? I mean, I wish it would've came with something else, but you know. The good thing about it, this guy comes with a whipping hand. And this guy just comes with the open hands. But you know, that's pretty cool that we actually have a Spider-Man with whipping hands. I really do like the web-slinging hands, so that's pretty cool. And let's just take a look at the packaging real quick. So here we got some pretty good artwork on the sides of the packaging. And then on the back, as you can see, this is an entirely new wave. I got almost all these figures except the Gray Hulk. And then on the side, I have all of these figures. So that's pretty cool. I do like these. I really do love these toy lines. I'm a big fan of Disney, a big fan of Marvel, and a big fan of Star Wars and Pixar. So these are right up my alley. I really do love these toys. So let's crack these bad boys open and see what we're working with. Boom! Here they are out of the packaging, and these figures are pretty, they're pretty sweet. I do like these figures. I did have this one before, and this is kind of just like a downgrade. It's just the paint apps are just totally downgraded from what this was before. And the Miles Morales figure is a total upgrade from the Peter Parker Spider-Man. So this figure is way better than this figure. In my opinion, I like them both, but Miles Morales probably takes the cake. He's this is how they should have did the sculpting on this figure. And another gripe about these figures is that they didn't really paint in the spider webs on the suit. They're more directed towards kids. I understand that, but I guess I wouldn't mind a little bit more paint decals on it, right? Like, yeah, give it a little bit more paint apps on it. So we'll do Spider-Man first, and then we'll take care of Miles Morales, and then the accessories they come with. Okay, first up we have our Spider-Man, our Peter Parker version of Spider-Man, and this figure is a little bit of a downgrade from what we had before when the toy line first released. The Spider-Man we got was more based off the Spider-Man Homecoming suit. This one is too, but what I mean by a downgrade is all of the black lines that were painted for, I don't know if you can catch it really good on my camera here, because I'm using a poor camera. They didn't paint in all of the black lines that should be painted in, and yeah, that's basically it with the, there's 3 points of articulation in the arms, in the legs, 1 point in the waist, and 1 point in the head area, the neck. And yeah, there's it moves just like every other Disney Infinity character toy box, Marvel toy box line. So yeah, there's not really much going on with Spider-Man here. But let's take a look at his accessory quick. Okay, so this is the accessory that both of the Spider-Men come with. It's just a little sticky suction cup that you can put on windows or other surfaces. And the webbing here, it kind of retracts really fast and hard, so you can't really get them to like hang or anything from anything. It won't dangle. You can't get it to lock in any position. It's just kind of a little boring. But yeah, it's meant for kids, like I said, so it's probably fun for the little ones, right? Right? Alright guys, here's the one that the reason for this review, Miles Morales Spider-Man, based off the Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse film. I can see why they did this, because of that movie, right? Just releasing last Christmas. And it was a great movie. I took my kids to go see it, and my youngest son just loved it. He did not blink through the whole movie. Pretty good movie. I really did enjoy it. I wasn't a big fan of Miles Morales, but after seeing that movie, I love Miles Morales. He's a great character, great story, great Spider-Man. So, like I said, Miles Morales, he's got 3 points of articulation in each arm. 1 point in the waist there, and then 3 points of articulation in the legs and feet area. He can also look up just a little bit, not too much. He can nod, yes, and then he can kind of nod no. Well, yeah, he can nod no, but as terms of going up and down, he can't really articulate too well in that area. But he can get them in his typical T pose. Like I said, there's his whipping hand, pretty cool compared to the Peter Parker Spider-Man's hands. See, he's just got plain hands where he can just hold objects, and he's got an open hand and a whipping hand. So that's pretty cool. I do like that. You got your peg holes at the bottom of the feet, barely see it, and then you got the red all around the feet. Like I said, though, I really do wish they kind of added like the spray paint effect to this. I can see why they didn't do that, but I think it would have been a bit more appreciated to do that, and also to color in the web lines a little more red, because it just looks a little bland, right? Looks a little plain, a little bare. But as in for the accessories with this guy, he comes with the exact same thing, just one of those suction cup web retractable toys. And yeah, that's basically it for the accessories with this guy. Okay, here's just a quick figure comparison to their Marvel Legends counterparts. On the left side, we have Peter Parker Spider-Man, and on the right side, obviously, is the Miles Morales Spider-Man. Pretty good figures. I really do like these figures, and I really do like their Marvel Legends counterparts. So that's pretty cool to have these. And here's just a quick figure comparison to your World of Nintendo action figures. Alright, you guys, that does it for this review. If you guys like this review, please subscribe. Hit that thumbs up if you guys want to. Leave a comment if you will. You guys know the drill. I am out of here. Peace out.